Welcome to this BEC podcast. My name is Rasmus Beck, and welcome to another podcast delivered by Badminton Europe. Today with two Dutch men entering the studio. Not that often that we have visits from the Netherlands, so thank you for coming, Robin Tabeling and Jelle Maas. And let's just jump to it. Jelle, it looks like you and Robin is actually doing a pretty good job at the moment here in 2018, the late 2018. Yeah. What is happening?
Yeah, we're playing really well. Actually, I think it started last year around December. We started winning the Scottish Open and then a few other tournaments. And yeah, we got into the groove and find the right tactics and balanced our games a bit and playing really well.
Robin, what is those small things that you have adjusted and doing better now compared to previously?
I think when we started, we were a little too eager, play the flat game, play the fast game. We're quite physical players and like to play the hard game, flat game, etc. I think we got a way better balance in it now, structured ourselves and as a couple into the matches. And like Jelle said, got into a good flow, took some good wins and some confidence with that. And I think the results we got from there just got better and better.
Mm. Yeah, looking at your results in 2018, there are some results that really are highlights, especially the ones you delivered in Asia in September, October month. What are those things that you have built up and which make you deliver these results also against the Asian pairs now and also against, for instance, Mathias Borchgrevink from Denmark?
I think we found the game rhythm we needed to have to beat those couples to like have a level that they are where we can challenge them as well. And yeah, we really practiced a lot with it, like tactic wise, but also positioning. Yeah, I think that gave us a big advantage.
Robin, let's take a bit of look on this victory you had against Mathias Borg and Carsten Mogensen. Previously, they have won the medals at the Olympics. What did that mean to you guys beating those two guys?
Well, it was a big win, of course, as they are at that moment we're still world number fives, have several titles in their pocket, and like you said, medals. Yeah, it was a huge victory. When in that particular match, I think we struggled for 1.5 set. They were leading, and I think after that we got a good grip on the match. And of course, when you take it home, if you can see our celebration, it meant a lot. Also because that victory took us to the quarterfinal, which is also our first quarterfinal. So yeah, I think on multiple occasions it was a good victory that gave a good confidence boost.
Mm. Yeah, let's be honest here. Are you surprised that you can actually beat a pair like them?
Yeah, actually I am. I used to watch those guys playing and they were like role models to me. So it was quite surprisingly that you're suddenly like on that level and that you can beat guys like that. And yeah, that's amazing.
What should we hope for you regarding the future, knowing that now you beat that top five pair? That means that you might be able to beat some more, but in the big picture, in the broader perspective, what can we expect from you guys moving forward from here then?
Yeah, I think that's our first win over top five couple, but we've played the next round against Sukumuyo and Gideon. I think we also there showed that we can play with them, but we need to be far more consistent. If we then take it on to the later week and now previous week Dutch Open, where we've beaten Angerwan and Hardianto, also a top 20 couple. So I think it showed that we can play with them, but we also had some losses. So yeah, don't shine the biggest light on us. I think we still need to develop, but we've shown that we can play with them, play with top 20 couples. And now, of course, our goal is to be a top 20 couple ourselves and challenge them on a daily basis and not only once, twice, maybe three times.
Mm. Looking at also at the European circuit, we've also seen Jaco Arens and Ruben Riehle also delivering good results in the men's doubles, winning Belgian International, for instance. Jelle, looking at the Dutch men's doubles, are the level higher now compared to just 1 or 2 years ago, in your opinion?
What we have now is like a good practice atmosphere. So we have like two good couples that can like make each other bigger and stronger. That helps us forward a lot. And if I compare that with 2 years ago, where we had Ruben and also Robin, when they came up from the juniors, you still have a few years to adjust. So I think now we have such a good group on men's doubles that we can make each other stronger and help each other grow.
But Jelle, how does it feel for you to know that those youngsters are up and coming, like you, Roman? Those youngsters are coming, and you need to be patient because you cannot expect them to deliver like they did on the youngster level, on the junior level, because the adaption to from junior to senior player, it's not an easy step to take.
No, it's not. But you used to be a junior as well, so I know how it is and what you need from the older players to help you develop as well. So for me, it's just natural and to help them and to make sure that you in a few years have a good atmosphere to practice in as well.
Mm-hmm. Robin, what did you learn from Jelle coming from the juniors to the seniors?
Well, like Jelle said, in the first years I was playing with Ruben, and they kicked our ass in the beginning. So they opened up our eyes like, this is not the way you have to play to get there. And then we switched, and I got the honor to stand beside him. Jelle is has a great overview over the matches. Like, it's really calm as I get more stressed and more hyped. Mm. And I think he helped me a lot with finding the right balance in the game, keeping patience, showing that it's not always about speeding up, but also taking the speed out. Mm. So he helped me a lot on that. And of course, he was experienced winning with Jaco some tournaments already, where I, as a newbie, got into it. Mm. So on some important matches, he took control of me and said, hey, calm down. It's okay. We're doing the right things. Mm. Even though we maybe lost the rally, he settled like, yeah, it's the right thing. And I think especially those key moments really helped me to have a more stable level.
Did you learn anything from the newbies, yeah?
Of course you do. I am still learning from him. So now it's always like when you're a new partnership, you have things where you can grow as a couple, but also as a person from the other partner. So no, I learned a lot of things from him.
I also think I'm really different than Jaco besides
yeah,
him.
Yeah, for sure.
How is Robert from Jaco?
Like, everybody knows Jaco Arends, of course, and he's mm-hmm. quite calm and relaxed, yeah. and he's more inside of himself. And Robin is like really expressing how he's feeling and what he's doing.
Talking
and like a lot of energy, yeah. And it really gives me energy to be on court with him. So
is it sometimes hard to deal with a talker like Robin?
No, not at all, huh? Actually. No.
Huh? Why?
I don't know. You find like a rhythm how you can communicate on the same level that you're giving each other the energy you need. Mm. So no, we find our way in it.
Yeah, that's good. That's good to hear. 2018 is getting closer to the end. 2019 coming to us very soon. What are the big things that you're looking for in 2019?
I think, like I said before, performing on a regular basis with the higher couples, of course. Mm. But in 2019, there's also this European Games event, of course, that excludes the European Championships from 2019. So, of course, we'll focus a little bit on that and try to make another medal in a big European tournament. Mm. But before we get there, we'll have a very busy schedule with the tournaments all over again, where we we'll try to perform even more consistent and, like I told you before, get to the top 20 ranking ourselves instead of just beating those couples up there. Mm.
Yeah, that European Games, let's just go back to that. Why is that important for you to perform well there?
It's a great event, of course, and we actually never played it. I never played it. So, it's great to show your abilities down there. So that's what we want to do.
And that fact that it's also a multi-sport event, does that do something, or is it like similar to for you in the mindset as a European championship?
No, it's going to be totally different, I think. Yeah. I'm not sure what to expect from it because I didn't go to the Olympics as well. So, it's just, let's see how it goes and what it is.
Looking at the Netherlands, it seems like you have some players that are developing quite fast. And we also saw at the European Juniors in Tallinn in September 2018 that you have some younger players like you, Robin, quite lately did that, moving in the right direction for the Netherlands. Robin, what's happening at the moment in the Netherlands that gives that effect that you're actually doing quite well, a lot of you?
I think there's multiple explanations, but like 4 to 6 years ago, our budget got cut and we had to start all over. And I think especially in the last 2 years, the environment we have now at Papendal again, where we practice daily with we have a pretty good staff around us, I think that's one of the reasons. And I think the other reason is that the mentality in the group has really grown. Our focus has been that we need to speak up to each other if we don't perform. And I think that has helped us a lot, delivering the quality of the practice. And if your practice quality gets higher and higher, I think your performance can be higher and higher. And as the juniors now also train on a daily basis at Papendal, they see us practice. And I think they also know that it's hard to get there, but if you have the right mind, you'll get there. And once or twice a week that they're joining and getting used to what they need to do in the future. And I think that's another big reason that will help the group, help the performances, and therefore also help with good results.
Hilla, within the last year, 1.5 years, we have heard a lot about Badminton England getting cut in funding. You have tried that as the Netherlands. How can you now evaluate that cut of funding and see, okay, how did we actually do despite of that cut in the Netherlands?
I think as the Netherlands, we did really well with it. You straight away get a like mentally changed thing in the group, because you really have to work for it, and everything you do is like you have to put in the effort. So like mental wise, it was really good for us, but yeah, it's still a struggle. If you're focusing on badminton, you need to be only focused on badminton, and with this cutting stuff, it's quite tough because you have to find the money somewhere else, and some things cannot be happened, and that's quite tough. But I think overall, if I look back, I think it was a good change for the Netherlands, especially for all the players.
So you were actually being growing, all of you guys, despite of the funding cut?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, we got a better mentality in the group.
Yeah, Ron?
Yeah, I think you could say so. I think also the Dutch board, the Federation of Badminton, really stepped up and made the situation as best as possible. And then the rest was up to us, where we, like Jelle said, you're not even putting your own effort in it, but also your own money. Mm. It's expensive to be a badminton player, especially if you're lowly ranked. Mm. That got, like Jelle said, the mentality in the group really high, as you don't want to waste your money, if I can say it like that. You want to make the best of it. And of course, that should be in your mind every time, but it hurts a little more when it's your own money.
So can we actually put it to this, that it might actually be made you better players, making you more responsible to take that funding cut? Yeah,
it's more about the whole group, I think. Maybe some people are not really committed to it, and then now you have a group that's fully committed to go, where the training goes up, like quality wise.
Exactly. I agree with that.
Yeah, we see pairs like Jaco and Selina being there for a while now. Everybody knows them. Most people also know you, Jelle. We see you, Robin, like one of the youngsters moving forward. We see a lot of the youngsters doing well at the moment. Where will we see Dutch badminton in, like, maybe not at Tokyo 2020, but the time after Paris 2024, and even moving further on? How do you see that?
I think what will be a major role in that is that in the last 2 years, we have had a group of juniors again that's practicing full time, where we missed that for the last, I think, 3-4 years. So if I look at the future, I think it's really important that they already having a basis now where they can practice on a good daily basis with good staff around them that will help them definitely perform in the next few years. I think you've mentioned it before. I think we're doing good as a group now, and we're having an average age of around 24, 25. So if you add a few more years to that, I think the group can still be there. With addition of some younger guys joining the group, it will only be bigger and bigger. And I foresee, hopefully, a bright future where we have a bigger group, and therefore even better training environment, etc.
Yeah, that we see that the Danes, of course, always doing good. That's just a fact. The English players will always have expectations regarding them. France is doing good at the younger stats as well. How high will we see the Netherlands be ranked? Will they be like a dominating nation, or or how do you see that?
It's always going to be tough to beat Denmark, of course. Mm. But we must strive to be in the top there, like battling with England, France, even Germany. Like we need to be up there, and I think we can, and we will try to be so.
Mm. if you guys and I sit here in around 2 years from now, the Olympics are over, do we have a Dutch medalist at the Olympics in Tokyo?
That would be great, but I don't think we're going to be... It's too high for now, I think.
I think it's one of the hardest things to win medals at the Olympics, where everybody is bringing their A game.
Mm.
Draw is, of course, also a little important. Mm. But I don't think you should not try it, but expecting it is maybe a little high.
And even just qualifying as a Dutch player for the Olympics might not be that easy either, right?
That's quite tough as
Completely
well.
Completely true.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not even based on the ranking. There's also...
We have some different qualification.
Yeah. Maybe try to enlighten the viewers a bit about that.
Since you mean the qualification
demands.
Yeah. Like in doubles, it's the same as BWF. You have to be top 16.
Mm.
So that's straightforward. But in singles, I think the BWF accepts a lot more players.
Mm.
But still, badminton, if you want represent badminton for the Netherlands at the Olympics, you have to be 16 as well in singles.
Mm.
So that's quite tough.
Is that fair, Jelle?
Is it fair? It's tough to say. The federation says that they want to have like medalist opportunities if you go there. So if that's their aim, then it's fair. But if you see players going that are not as good as the players we have, then it's not fair, of course.
No. That was 2 years from now. If we see 1 year from now, what title have you won in 1 year from now, you guys?
Ooh. That's a good question. A title. Then,
leaving the youngster to answer that.
Yeah, just let him struggle a bit. No, I would say the European Games. That's one of our goals.
European Games, yeah.
Especially a medal. At least a medal. And let's make it a better color than we have already.
Yeah. So you're going for the gold in Minsk?
Yeah, that would be great.
Let's leave it on that note. Yeah. Thank you guys for stopping by. Thank you very much for watching this edition of the BC podcast. Remember to follow our platforms and download the new app if you don't have it already. Then you can follow these guys as a favorite player, get the live scores and whatsoever, news, match reports, all that you can find in our new app, Badminton Live. Thank you very much for watching, and see you until next time.